Okay, good day guys, good day to you all. Welcome back to the Formula Sports Channel. Thanks again for being here. Gentle reminder, smash the like button guys and subscribe as well. These are free and easy ways to support the channel by liking the video and subscribing to the channel if you haven't already. And of course, as always, big thank you for all the support the channel has received thus far. So you guys see the title of the video. Before we get into that though, just a quick shout out to Alvis Powell. When I dropped my video on Alvis Powell earlier today, a couple of minutes, probably less than half an hour later, FC Cincinnati confirmed that they had signed Reggae Boy Alvis Powell. So congratulations on Alvis Powell. My video was basically talking about the deal was close to done, but you know, about less than half an hour later, FC Cincinnati confirmed the deal, right? So let's get into it now. The Panama job just got a bit easier. Now you guys know that we have this big upcoming game on January the 30th against Panama in Panama, right? A place we have never gone to. Have you ever? I don't think we have ever won in Panama, if I'm not mistaken. Don't quote me on that, but if I'm not mistaken, I'm going off memory right now, but I don't think we have ever won in Panama. Correct me in the comment section if I am wrong on that. Regardless, it is a very, very, very tough place for Jamaica to go and get a result, right? We all know Panama is a tough place, right? For Jamaica, we have not received a lot of joy in Panama, right? But here's the thing, no, here's the thing, guys. Could this particular trip to Panama be an easier encounter for us, right? I'm going to tell you guys why this trip to Panama might be a bit easier for us, right? On the screen, I am on the FIFA website and I am looking at the FIFA disciplinary committee decisions, right? Now, when you look on this list, you see Panama. What is Panama doing on this list, you may ask? I'll tell you what Panama is doing on this list. Panama versus Costa Rica and Panama versus Mexico. The 2nd of September 2021 and the 8th of September 2021, right? Those games, Panama is being disciplined for those games because of fan indiscipline, right? So it is alleged that homophobic, right? Slangs or homophobic language. It is alleged that this was used, right, in the Panama National Stadium by Panamanian fans. And we all know that when it comes to that sort of a thing, FIFA is going to be very strict on it, right? And because of that, FIFA has disciplined Panama, right? So they're going to have to pay a fine of 50,000 Swiss francs. But most importantly, the 50,000 Swiss francs don't affect us. What affects us is that Panama will have a stadium ban. You heard it, guys. Panama will have an empty stadium for our game on June the 30th against them. Guys, this will make this Panama game a whole lot easier. Don't get me wrong, it's still going to be a tough encounter. Still going to be a very tough encounter, but the mere fact that we won't have to go to Central America and have to contend with those hostile Central American fans, right? The energy inside that Panama Stadium is crazy. I've watched, you know, Panama home games in this particular World Cup qualifiers, and the energy in that stadium is electrifying, right? I'm telling you, man. I won't go as far as saying this has basically turned it into a neutral venue, but for sure, this will make the Reggae Boys job a lot easier, right? Not saying it's going to be an easy contest, but it's going to be a bit easier, right? Considering the fact that we won't have to be playing against 12 men, we'll only be playing against 11 men. We won't have to contend with the 12th man. With that being said, though, still going to be a difficult game, still going to be a top game. And the thing about it is, this game could arguably decide whether or not we get to Qatar, yes or no. If we win this game, we are in big, big business. This is a big, big game. Arguably, not even arguably, more than likely the biggest test of Paul Hall's managerial career thus far. This game in Panama City, for sure. It's a massive game. So it's a huge relief to hear that we won't have to contend, right, with Panamanian fans. It is a huge relief to hear that we won't have to deal with the 12th man. Trust me, it, you know, is a bit of luck coming our way, guys. A bit of luck. I don't know, the footballing gods, right, smiling on Jamaica, right? The footballing gods want to see Jamaica in Qatar. Let's see. I am seeing unconfirmed reports that there was an appeal. So if you notice and this is unconfirmed, right? I have not confirmed it, tried desperately did a lot of research, trying to confirm it, but I didn't manage to confirm it. But I'm seeing a number of reports saying that basically there was an appeals process, right? And that's why, because what happened, if you look on the screen, you'll realize that the offenses took place way back in September, right? They are just now being enforced for Panama's next upcoming home game, which is in January, right? So I'm seeing unconfirmed reports that there was some sort of an appeals process. I don't know how true that was or how true that is, but if it is indeed that those unconfirmed reports are true, it would make sense as to, you know, why the decision would have taken so long to have been enforced, right? The particular, I saw it on multiple platforms, but the particular platforms that I saw it on, you know, them basically saying that there was an appeals process, those particular platforms, when I did the research, there weren't platforms that I would, you know, run with what they're saying. Not that they're shady platforms or anything like that, but the due diligence, I wasn't satisfied, you know, as to whether or not they met the standard. These respective platforms met the standard, my required standard of credibility, right? So that's why I say unconfirmed reports, right? And next story that I want to share with you guys quickly is concerning reggae boy Kevon Lambert. If I can just get that up on the screen very quickly. There we go. Arizona Sports 98.7 FM, right? They basically ran a story on their website talking about some transfer activity in relation to the Phoenix Rising. The Arizona Sports 98.7 FM is a credible platform, and it's the home to the Cardinals, the Suns, the D-backs, the Coyotes, ASU, and the Phoenix Rising, right? And this platform ran a story, you know, talking a bit about transfer activity, or, you know, player movement activity in relation to the Phoenix Rising. If you notice right here, number six, it's on your screen so you can read it. Number six midfielder Kevon Lambert finds himself in a similar situation, as the Jamaican is also a free agent after a little more than four seasons with the Phoenix Rising FC, and turns 25 years old in March. Phoenix Rising is still in ongoing negotiations with several players and has now 17 players signed to its roster ahead of the 2022 USL season. Now, here's the thing with this, right? Here is the thing with this. We don't know when they say ongoing negotiations with several players, right? We don't know who these players are. You know, Kevon Lambert could be a part of it. He could be a part of the 17 players. He might not, right? We don't know what the situation is. All we know is that his contract, you know, according to a credible source, his contract is up. I went on his respective social media handles, and I didn't see anything as it relates to like a goodbye message. You know, when I mean, he has been there for 4 seasons now, right? He has gotten over 100 caps. He has made over 100 appearances for Phoenix Rising, right? And this is a young midfielder, right? Who is a very, very, very important player for them, right? He turns 25 in March, so he's 24 right now, right? 24 years old, has another, what, probably 10 years, a decade, if not a decade, close to a decade, right? So it kind of strikes me as a bit odd that Phoenix would allow this player, you know, to leave on a free, right? And a very important player that a starter for the Phoenix Rising, a successful, a relatively successful, you know, stint with the Phoenix Rising, both individually and collectively. So it kind of surprised me where that is concerned. I don't know what's the situation there. As I said, I don't see any goodbye message from Kevon Lambert to the club. You'd imagine that, you know. I mean, look at Flemo, for instance. I know everybody's not gonna do the same thing. You can't hold everybody to the same standard, but Flemo did a goodbye message to Birmingham Legion. He was only there for a year. Kevon Lambert made over 100 appearances for this respective club over 4 seasons. I don't see any goodbye, any parting messages. I don't know if that's soon to come. I don't know what's the situation here. Is he being presented with a better opportunity elsewhere? And so he did not want to re-sign. I don't know. All I know is that Kevon Lambert is a free agent at the moment. So we'll continue to monitor that particular story and see what happens with Mr. Kevon Lambert. We wish him all the best, you know, on his hunt for, I don't want to say a new club, but a new contract. So, guys, that's my 2 cents gentle reminder. Smash the like button, subscribe if you're new. Until next time.